Usually we would have checked back in with Nate at the weather wall, but he's actually ducked out to chat to our next guest. Nate, where are you?
Paris. Melbourne, at the Regent Theatre morning team. The Moulin Rouge, everyone in Melbourne's talking about it. And news out this morning, it's going to Sydney. So exciting for the Harbour City. So I thought I'd pop down to this stunning theatre to have a chat to a couple of the cast. Simon Burke, I remember him from play school. And Tim O'Margi, who I remember as Tim O'Matic. Welcome, gentlemen, to breakfast. Yes. So exciting, Sydney. Tim, you're a Sydney boy. Yes. Are you thrilled to be taking this home?
100%. You know, the weather is coming. we are so excited to come home. I'm a Botany boy. And, it's going to be great to celebrate it with some family that have not seen the show yet. So, and they don't know what this looks like, what I sound like, what I'm doing out here in Melbourne, but they're going to see very soon.
Actually, everybody looks and sounds incredible in this piece. And, Simon, I didn't even recognise you for the first maybe 5 minutes because you've just absolutely transformed.
Yeah.
Tell me about being part of this show.
Look, I've done heaps of musicals in my time and, you know, here and in the UK, but I've got to say there's nothing like the excitement of doing this show. I think it's something to do with the fact that the movie is so well loved. It's the 20th anniversary of the movie. So everyone comes with a knowledge and a memory, like their first kiss when they went to see the film, or they grew up as a little kid watching it. And it's just, there's such an energy when we go and see the movie. The musical was kind of like the musical sort of on steroids. It just goes, as you've seen, yeah.
Yeah, so 20 years this year since Moulin Rouge, the movie started, and, first aired, and the music has all been incredibly updated. Is it tough? Like, I know listening to the music from the movie and then listening to it on stage, I wanted to sing along, but it's updated in exciting ways. Do you ever get the words wrong?
No, I don't. Anything wrong?
Yes.
No, not quite. But shout out to Justin Levine, who arranged all this crazy new music for the show. But it is that excitement of the crowd going, hey, I know that song, and I know that one, and I know, and that one's from the original, and I know this one and that one. It's just so great to see it. And I think because we haven't had an audience for so long, when we finally had one and seeing the songs land, it was like, oh, they find it funny and they find it, wow, that's how it actually lands. So it's such a crazy ride to be a part of. So much fun.
And such a thrill to be an audience member as well. Simon, there's quite a lot going on in this. It's not just a bit of singing. It's also incredible dancing and, athletics, and there's magic going on and all sorts of things happening on the stage all the time. How long did you spend on this? Because it was meant to open back in August, right?
Yeah, we were scheduled to open in August. So actually, we all got together for the first time 5 months ago. So to be in a kind of bubble as we were, a work bubble for 5 months, just, working on the show but not having an audience. The day that we went in front of an audience on the 12th of November, it was the most electric, I think one of the most exciting nights of my life, because we've been together, as Tim said, as a company and not quite, you know, knowing that the audience was the next thing that had to be added, as it always is. But in this show, they go crazy. And also because people haven't been out for such a long time. Yeah. This show is kind of a celebration. This show is like 18 months of Melbourne sort of in lockdown. They get 18 months worth of entertainment in one night. So people are just loving it. It's really cool.
Absolutely, we get entertainment from people that we know and love on the stage, but also some newcomers. Tell us a bit about the cast.
So we have the leads, Christian and Satine, played by Dez and Alinda. And, incredible people. I haven't met Dez and Alinda till this show, and we're already very, very good friends. They just, their love story and the way that their chemistry just comes alive every night is something worth seeing, honestly. And I get to see it up close, and it just makes working and coming to work so enjoyable. Even, you know, having the pleasure of sharing the stage with Mr. Simon Burke.
Yeah.
Honestly, we have too much fun. We're not allowed to have this much fun, but I think it's working and I think the audience are loving it. But incredible cast, all the dancers, everyone backstage. It's honestly been the most humbling experience for me on stage in how much unity it's been, from everyone in this production and how much we've had to endure to get it here. So Sydney, get ready. Wow.
Last time I saw Alinta, she was playing Mary Poppins. So this is a heck of a different role. She's so wonderful, as is Des and the rest of the cast. When can Sydney Siders expect to see you, Simon?
We open in Sydney on the 28th of May. I think tickets go on sale from the 16th of December, Ticketmaster. And we play in Melbourne. We're still in Melbourne until the 29th of April. And, yeah, come along and see if you haven't seen it in Melbourne yet.
And I'm going to leave you my phone number so that if there's ever an empty seat, you can I can pop right down
I'll
for another
that.
Show.
Yeah, cool.
Okay, awesome, awesome. Well, boys, thank you so much. Now, Michael and Lisa sort of challenged me earlier. They said, well, you can't go to the Moulin Rouge and not do the Can-Can. So, you're both experts. Would you mind maybe giving it a go with me?
She's probably more of an expert at dancing than me, but we could...
Five, throw six, it. Seven, eight.
Oh, there we go. There you go, team.
Basic step.
I can do the can. Yeah. Done. And I tell you what, Lisa, especially, you need to get down to see this show.
Lisa.
It is amazing.
Oh, Nate, I love it. You actually did it. Can you please thank them very much? That is a big ask early in the morning, not only to get into costume, but to then try and teach you the can. Brilliant work, everyone.
Thanks, Lisa and Michael as well. They've said thank you very much. Obviously, we have had enough coffee this morning.
Yeah, clearly. Go and have another one. Thank you, Nate.